And in case of last observation, I have an observation that deviates from the mean on, by 1 unit on the higher side. So in order to calculate the standard deviation, that is the average dispersion of any observation from the mean, we need the sum of dispersion of all observations from the mean. That will be summation x minus mu. And as the standard deviation from the data source of the population is being represented by a sigma. So when I will going to carry out the summation, I just need to, when I need to sum all of them. So this will be sum of x minus x bar, and that will be equal to, if you just add everything from the top, this is minus 1, this is 0, and this is plus 1. If you add all of them at the end of the day, what you will going to get? You will get a value that is 0. And that is a limitation of mathematics, that it cancels the negative value from positive value. And with every data set, at any time, when you will going to calculate x, summation x minus x bar, it will always come up with a total value of 0. Because some observations, they will be higher from the mean, and some of them, they will be lower end of the mean. And the higher values, they will going to cancel the lower values, and at the end, whatever data you have, with every data set, every time you will going to get summation x minus x bar, that will always equal to 0. And this is a limitation of mathematics. Because here, just try to understand the concept. The first observation is 1 unit below the mean. So it's at a distance of the mean. For example, if this is my mean, so I have one observation that is 1 unit below from the mean. So it's 1 unit below from the mean. So that does not mean that there is no distance between this observation and the mean. Yes, there is a distance. And that distance is 1 unit. On the lower side, but still it's a distance. And you have another observation that is on the higher side of the mean, and once again it's 1 unit. And you have a third observation that is exactly on the mean, so it is not anywhere else, it is right exactly on the mean. But still, this observation is 1 unit below the mean, this unit observation is 1 unit above the mean. So they are dispersed from the mean. They are not on the center. But when we use mathematical calculations, we have to just, when we try to solve that, we will get a value of the minus 1. And then for higher value, I will going to get a value of plus 1. This is being declared by the mathematical calculations minus 1, because it's on the lower side and I have a numeric value that is less than the mean. But when you look at the dispersion or the distance, it is away from the mean. So if this observation is away from the mean and if your third observation is also away from the mean, in that case the sum of dispersion cannot be 0. It must be, the sum of dispersion must be, if I were going to add all the dispersion, that is 1 plus 1, it must be 2 units. Because one observation is dispersed by 1 unit, and then another observation that is also dispersed by 1 unit. And then we talk about the dispersion. We do not care whether it's on the higher side or it's on the lower side. But we have to follow the rules of mathematics. And at any time, when you have a situation like this, that you know that this is not 0, the dispersion is not 0, the sum of dispersion is not 0, but when we use the mathematical calculations, unfortunately, via trick, we always get a value of 0. Because when we we apply the rule of mathematics, the minus values, they cancel the plus values. And we cannot simply remove that minus sign, because no one will going to accept that, that when you are going to subtract the 3 from the 2, you get a value of plus, no, it's plus 1. No, it's not possible. So that's very, very, very much common practice, that at any time when you have a mathematical limitations like this, what's the solution? The people, they come up with a solution that just clear the value first, and then at the end, what you need to do, that you just need to take the under root. So when you are going to clear that, that minus value eventually will become positive. And then in that case, your sum of square deviation, it's not simple deviation, it's sum of square deviation from the mean, will you will have a genuine value that is, that I just by mistake wrote a word like x bar. Do not use the x bar when you have a data from the population. Use the symbol of mu, and that's what I have represented it. Because I have, most of the time I deal with samples, so I always write x bar. That's the mistake from my side. So x bar minus mu is square. I have a genuine value that is equal to 2. And once I have a squared deviation of the observation from the mean, ultimately in later on in the formula, if you can see from my previous lecture, that I just need to take the under root and I will get the value. Rule number 58. Is it clear?
Yes, sir. Sir, yes, I have another question.
Yes.
Sir, in second step, x minus mu, always x minus mu value always be zero?
Summation, sum of x minus mu will always be zero. And that's why we scare it. You can just practice, you can use any data set. I'm just using some simple figures to make my calculations easy and to do it fast, because I'm not good when it comes to the writing with a mouse. So I'm using these very, very simple values, but just try to practice with 10 data set, 15 data set, that may have many, many observations. Still, you will, at the end of the day, what you are going to get is a value of zero. Fine.
Okay, sir.
Do you have any other question? Just feel comfortable and ask.
No, sir, it's clear. Thank you.
So that concludes my discussion on standard deviation when you have a data from the population. So as you know that you do not calculate directly standard deviation, average dispersion of the observation from the mean, that is how we define it, the average dispersion of the observation from the mean, as you do not directly calculate standard deviation, rather you first square the values and then take the under root because of that limitation. So people, they come up with another way tool to find out the center. And that tool, we name it as the variance. So how we define the variance is average squared deviation of observations from the mean. And the concept of variance came from that, okay, we calculate too much for this. So how we define the variance? We define the variance as average square deviation of observation from the mean or average square dispersion of observation from the mean. It means the same. So what's the purpose of doing this? Because people, they realize that they have to square it. So this is dispersion word, D-I-S-P-E-R-S-I-O-N. So you can replace the deviation by dispersion. So both means the same. So we define the variance as average square dispersion of observations from the mean, average square deviation of observations from the mean. It both means the same. What people, they have realized that we have to square it because of that specific mathematical representation. So people, they came up with an idea that, okay, we can represent the dispersion in the squared form. And if a dispersion is being represented in the form, squared form, people, they can calculate directly by just taking the under root. So they will going to understand that, okay, it's a squared dispersion that is being represented. So variance become very, very much popular among all those people who deals with statistics. And it's the average squared dispersion of the observation from the mean. And the formula for variance in case of population, we represent the variance of a population by sigma square, and sigma square is equal to summation x minus mu, so this is mu, that is mu refers to the population mean, square divided by, we represent the total number of observations in case of population by a capital N. So it will become this. And this is the formula we already used, mean that fraction. This is nothing else but that fraction. Only the square root, under root is missing. So in modern science, it's absolutely okay that either you will going to use variance to represent the dispersion, or you use standard deviation to represent the dispersion. When you will going to use the variance, people, they directly understand that it's a square dispersion. And once again, it's an average square dispersion. So it's average square deviation of observation from mean. So once again, you can just split the formula. X minus mu is the deviation of observation from the mean. And here it's squared. So it's a squared deviation of the observation from the mean. At the end, what you need to do is sum in order to get this average. So that section of the formula, bracket x minus mu square, it refers to the squared deviation of observation from the mean. So it can be any observation. So in order to get the average, you need a summation, and then that must be divided by total number of observations. I think that will be very, very simple concept for you, because you already understand the standard deviation. Is it okay? Just update me so that I can continue.
Yes, sir, it's clear.
Okay. So in as variance is average square deviation of the observations from the mean. So somewhere in the literature, you will going to see a definition of I just need to switch to previous slide. So I'm adding a new definition of the standard deviation, because we define the standard deviation as average dispersion or deviation of observation from the mean. Another definition of standard deviation is square root of variance is also known as the standard deviation. So somewhere in the literature, you will definitely going to see a word like this. Square root of variance is known as the standard deviation. But I will not going to recommend you that that definition is nothing else. But this definition tells us about the formula, how it works. That normally if you have a variance, just take the square root of variance and you will going to get the standard deviation. Once you have a standard deviation, that's how it works. That there are two things. One is the variance. And other thing is standard deviation. So how it works? Variance is nothing else but a square of standard deviation. Square of standard deviation. And the standard deviation is nothing else but a square root of variance. So if someone has given you standard deviation, you just need to square it and it will become variance. And if someone has given you a variance, you just need to take the square root and you will going to get a value of standard deviation. Is it okay? Is it okay? Are you listening?
Yes, sir.
Perfect. Now, whatever I have discussed as far as the dispersion is concerned, I just told you that in case of population, it is being represented by sigma square, and in case of when we need to represent the variance, in case of sample, it is being represented by S square. So, when you need to calculate the dispersion and you have data from the sample, in that case, the formula for the standard deviation will be like this. S is represents the standard deviation. S is equal to, so it's the standard deviation of the when you want to calculate the standard deviation of the sample. So I just move switching to the slide of standard deviation. Okay. So when you have a data of sample, we calculate the standard deviation, we represent the standard deviation by S. It's milliliter, na? Because आपने 1000 ml बनाना था. So S is equal to, we represent the standard deviation of the sample by S. S is equal to summation, the formula will remain as it is, summation X, X refers to any observation, minus, instead of mu, now you're going to use the sign of X bar, and because X bar refers to the mean of, so it switched to some wrong. So it will be like this, summation X minus X bar. So it's the sample mean. So that is being represented by X bar, square and then normally in case of population you divide it by total number of observation, that is capital N. While in case of sample, the total number of observation, they are being represented by small n. But along with that, you just need to subtract the one from n.
Excuse
so
me,
instead
me?
Of yes
sir,
why is not visible?
Isn't it visible?
So it is visible, but its variance.
I'm going to remove it and I'm going to put it again. Is it visible now?
Yes, sir.
Anyone, is there any person whose screen is who cannot see the presentation? Please confirm me. Is there anyone? Is it visible to everyone? Standard deviation, and then I have some strange writing in red color. Is it visible to everyone?
Yes.
So the formula where I was writing and you were you just fail here. So a standard deviation is being represented by S. So the formula will become S is equal to summation X minus X bar, because we represent the sample mean by X bar, and then square divided by N. N must be small because it's from the sample. But when we calculate the standard deviation from the sample, we use N minus 1 instead of N. Because you know that any characteristic of a sample, just try to remember my previous lecture, that in case of a population, you have a parameter. In case of parameter, you have a fixed value. While in case of sample, the characteristic of sample, we name it as the statistic, and it has a random value. So in order to be on the safe side, we use N minus 1 instead of N. And when I just reduce the N, because I just subtracted 1 from the N, so ultimately what will going to happen, that the value of the standard deviation will be on a little bit on the higher side. Because we know that in case of sample, whatever value we will get, it has a random value. So the only difference is that in the formula you have N minus 1 instead of N. Is it clear? Everything else will remain same, just N minus 1 instead of N. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
And then you have to square root it, because you know that in case of standard deviation is square root it, everything same. The only difference is that you have N minus 1 instead of N. Is it okay? And in case of the variance, we represent the sample variance by S square, and your formula will become like this: summation X minus X bar square divided by N minus 1. And if it will be standard deviation, you just need to take the, there is no other difference in formula of sample and the population, except that in case of population, you use N, you divide it by N, and in case of sample, you divide it by N minus 1. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now just listen for 5 minutes very, very carefully, because that's the most important concept I want to share, because these few things, they were calculations and just you can notice, but the real concept is I'm discussing it right now. Let me just a new slide. So when either it's a standard deviation or it's a variance, it's dispersion. Do you agree with this? It's a dispersion and it's average dispersion. So when it is dispersion and it's an average dispersion, can anyone tell me whether that average dispersion will be on the higher side or will it be on the lower side? Any volunteer? That's the critical question. So either it's an average square deviation of observation from the mean, or it's just average deviation of observation from the mean in case of variance and the standard deviation. I am asking that this average is. Please mute your mic. If you have any question, just feel free to ask. Otherwise, please mute your mic. Okay. Are you listening?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So just answer this question, that what do you think? That at any time, when you have average dispersion, this dispersion is either on the higher side or it's on the lower side. This average dispersion. This average square deviation is either on the higher side or lower side. The concept of variance and standard deviation is nothing else. One is square and other one is without square.
Sir, higher your lower
pin,
yogi will remain the same.
How it will remain the same? What do you mean by this? I'm talking about average deviation. For example.
No,
sir, yes.
No, sir, you can continue.
There is distortion in your voice.
I said you can continue.
So for example, if I have a mean of 14 and my standard deviation is 3. What does this mean? That on average, the observation they deviate from the mean by 3 units. Is this deviation is on the higher side or is on the lower side? This deviation is on both sides. What does this mean? That on average, the values they deviate by 3 units both on the, it's possible that they can be on the higher side and they can be on lower side. So at any time you will going to see in the literature, they will going to use a word like this. When they are representing the mean along with the standard deviation, they represent it like this: 14 plus minus 3. This means that the dispersion is on both sides, and this is average dispersion, that on average an observation can deviate by 3 units on the lower side and 3 units on the higher side. Because when it comes to the deviation, it has nothing to do whether it's on the higher side or it's on the lower side, it will remain a dispersion. And you do not need to, that's why people use both words, plus and minus. Is it okay? And when it comes to the variance, once again, the story will, for example, I have a mean of this and I have a variance of 9. And they will going to write it like this: 14 plus minus and then 9. What does this mean? That on average, the observation on average, the square dispersion of observation, it is by 9 units. Those 9 units can be on the lower side and those 9 units can be on the higher side. Is it clear? Anyone has any confusion, just feel free.
Sir, the formula doesn't tell us whether it's on the higher side or the lower side, or we just make it that way that it can be on both sides.
Mean the, because when it comes to the dispersion, for example, if you have an observation that is 3 and your mean is 9, what you are going to say from here? This observation is 6 units away from the mean. And they are 6 units, although we use a negative sign because it's on the lower side. But still, it's a distance. If some observation is, let's suppose I have an observation that is 15 and it's on the higher side of the mean. And let's suppose my mean is 9, but still it's a distance. And once again, it's a distance. We are looking for the deviation. We are looking for this distance. That's why the negative sign and the positive sign in of all those stuff, what we deal with mathematics, we just try to remove them by scaling and then taking the under root. Because we know this is a distance, although through mathematical calculations, it's giving me minus sign. Minus sign indicates it's on the lower side, and the plus sign it indicates on the higher side. So you have dispersion both on the lower side as well as on the higher side. If you just try with 100 kinds of data, you will not going to get any data which do not have what dispersion mean. If it has some dispersion, it must be on the lower side as well as on the higher side as well. There's one possibility that you get a value of exactly 0. For example, if I have 4 observations and every observation is 9, so it's identical. So in that case, my mean will be 9 and my standard deviation will be 0. My variance will be 0 because every observation is identical. Other than this case, that means here you do not see any dispersion. Other than this case, with every data set, I just challenge you with this, that just try to bring a data set where you do not see a dispersion on the lower side as well as on the higher side. Whenever it has a dispersion, it must have a dispersion on the higher side as well as on the lower side. So it's on the both sides. Because this is one more demonstration. Let's suppose I have a data like this, 3, 5, 9, 15. In order to have a 0 dispersion on the lower side, my mean must be 3. Do you think it's possible? In order to have a 0 dispersion on the lower side, my mean must be 3. Do you think it's possible? The mean is somewhere here. In order to have 0 dispersion on the higher side, my mean must be 15, but it's not possible. Because you know it's sum of all observations, and then you need to divide by total number of observations. And when you are going to divide it, you will definitely going to get mean somewhere here. And it must have, will have some values that is on the lower side and some values that will be on the higher side. Even with extreme case, for example, if I have, although it's in case of extreme values, you do not, the mean is not suitable to represent the center. But even with extreme case, if I have a data like this, let's suppose it. So if I have, let's suppose a data of 1.5 million. So this, my last observation is 1.5 million. Still, the mean cannot be 1.5 million exactly. It will be less than 1.5 million. And even in this case, if the mean is somewhere here, I have a dispersion on the higher side as well as I have a dispersion on the lower side. Because the mean cannot be on extreme of any side. So it cannot be exactly 3, so it cannot be exactly 1500. It must be less than 1500 and it must be greater than 3. So you add with every data set, you will going to see a dispersion both on the higher side as well as lower side. Have you got the concept?
Yes, sir.
Anyone has any question, just feel comfortable and ask. So that's why at any time when you try to represent, describe your data set, from your previous understanding, you know that is, you cannot describe a data set when that is being measured on interval scale without telling about the center and without telling about the mean or telling about the dispersion. So these are two things that describes the data set. So let's suppose your mean is 15. And when they describe the dispersion, they describe it like this, plus, minus 3. It can be standard deviation, it can be variance. And the standard deviation and the variance, they are very, very popular because they take into the account each and every observation. As they take into the account every observation, so we use standard deviation as well as variance in our inferential statistics. That's the huge advantage of standard deviation and dispersion variance. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So let me switch and, but these are all formulas what we have done so far, but that is all manual statistics. And when it comes to doing stuff in modern science, we normally have a huge data sources. Let me update. And you need to know how to work using those softwares. So I'm just uploading a Microsoft Excel file. And now we're going to discuss how to calculate the mean, standard deviation, using Microsoft Excel. Can you see a Microsoft Excel file on your screen?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Is there anyone in this class who do not have a basic understanding of Microsoft Excel? Rather, I will switch my question. Is there anyone who is familiar with Microsoft Excel? Has already worked with Microsoft Excel?
क्लास सर कह रहे हैं कि लाइट चली गई तो मैं डिस्कनेक्ट हो गई हूँ, तो अब नेक्स्ट क्लास में कंटिन्यू करूँगा, तो लीव कर दें.
ओके
ओके.